much is your kid squirreling away? What are they stashing? May it be money. May it be something that you found. I was bringing this up yesterday, my little black bean peen, my June, my Buna. We've come to find out that my son, God love Gavin, but if he gets a dollar, he spends a dollar.
Yeah.
I mean, it burns a hole in his pocket like a tourist in Vegas.
Yeah, you got to teach him to save.
Trying. I don't know much about much, but my kids are going to learn to save and spend money. No asteroids machines for them. And we come to find out that my stepdaughter, she's got this little box. I think a bath bomb came in. It looks like a shoebox, but it's smaller. And we're cleaning up her room, and we open this thing up, and it's wads of money.
Hell yeah.
It's just packed with money. And much in the same way my dad found my porn mag stash back in the day, he organized it very nicely, which gave me permanent anxiety this day to see that he found all my copies of We and High Society and organized them, I think alphabetically. One of them was missing. And Dad, I know you stole it. I think it was Swank. We took her money and laid it out to organize it for her. Ones and fives and tens and twenties. I think there was 100 in there.
Go ahead.
She was like $40 shy of $1,000.
$1,000? See, Stella's got like $300 or $400.
That's a good rip.
Yeah.
I mean, she's not even 10 yet. June's 12, and she's just been saving all of her money. It's wild. She's got a grip. And thank God she doesn't have really any sketchy relatives. The, you know, curmudgeonly down on his luck uncle, the one tweaky, methy aunt.
Stealing it.
That was good. Yes, because this stuff is just in a box. And we started to hear from people saying, yeah, my kid's got like, you know, $800 saved, $100 saved. Somebody sent in yesterday, their kid, I think they were mowing lawns the past couple of seasons, doing like, you know, landscaping stuff on the table, $2,000.
That's a good hustle.
That's
man.
A great hustle. That's amazing. So 410-338-1098, want to ask you, you know, how much has your kid got saved? How much have they got stashed?
Yeah, I want to know if we'll talk money, but also have you maybe just happened upon another kind of stash, something you found?
Oh, yeah. Found a little bit of that jazz cabbage.
I mean, it could be anything.
Yeah, we're going to open this up. Cash, how much have they squirreled away? Like some insane old woman that retires or is found dead and she's got like $50 million and she lived in a shack. Or you found something else, not money. Maybe something concerning, maybe something shocking. Who knows? Like a coin collection. Oh, God, I had no idea my 8-year-old was 90. 410-338-1098. 410-338-1098. What is your kid stashing? They don't know you know. But you know. You know where it's hidden. What have they got stashed away in their room? Hundreds, thousands? Maybe they've got some porn collection that would make Larry Flint blush? 410-338-1098. Call us after Bobby.
Yeah. 410-338-1098. 410-338-1098. What your kids got stashed? They got some money that they've been saving? Or maybe they're you stumbled upon something else in their room? We're getting a good mix of both here.
Yeah, give it to me.
Well, I'll give it to you.
Give it to me real good.
I'll give it to you.
Ow, Daddy.
Somebody said they found... this was a different one. It just made me think of something that, not a kid's stash, but when I was a teenager, I found my dad's weed hidden in one of those old film canister containers.
Oh, yeah.
Do you remember the little film
little
things?
Black film?
Yeah.
Dude, flashbacks.
You remember the smell of them? The way, like, the film smelled and all that?
Get a little bit of that chemical on your bud.
Dude.
Wow, that is funny.
What else do we have here?
In that same vein.
Yeah.
If you'd like, I come home one day and I go to bed. I'm 17 years old and I go to sleep.
What time? And are you sober?
No, I'm stone cold sober. And it's like 10 o'clock. And I wake up and I hear my dad in the living room coughing. And he had that like smoker's cough from yesterday. I wake up and I peer. My bedroom was not far from the living room. And I kind of like peer. That son of a bitch is holding my bong.
Your bong.
He found my
he's ripping it
home. And he's pulling tubes. Dad is pulling tubes. You sneaky Pete. And this was the bong that this is the bong that Greg Eckler and I made out of a 10-speed bike. You know where the pedal mechanism is? We basically sawed off each side up and then used Snapple caps and caulk to seal in the little gear mechanism area. And that's where the water went. So one end mouth, one end weed. And we drilled like a little hole for the carb. And that was my first bong.
Wow.
A homemade 10-speed bong.
Oh, my God. Ingenuity.
I knew where I stashed it, which was the top drawer of my dresser that my dad never went in. I immediately get wide-eyed. I run into my room. I pull open my dresser. I've never seen this much folded laundry.
Yep.
He just decided to be Betty Crocker. He decided to be Martha Stewart and just do my laundry.
My mom definitely found my porn stash doing laundry.
That sucks, yes.
Stack of nudie magazines this high.
Yeah, baby.
Somebody says, I used to mow lawns as a kid, and he would hide his money in spent shotgun shells that he got from hunting with his dad. And a couple of years ago, he was going through old boxes and found $500 inside these old shotgun shells.
Damn, okay.
What else? I had another one. This thing is bumping all around on me here. I found condoms in my son's room. I was horrified but proud at the same time.
Yeah, that's a double-edged sword there. Oh, God, my baby's, laying pipe, but he's doing it responsibly. So in that moment, do you have a conversation? Or are you like, I'm glad someone had the conversation. He's using them.
The only issue with the conversation is then they're going to think that you invaded their privacy.
Yeah, that's one of those things where you don't have privacy.
Right.
As long as
you're under my roof.
Yeah, that's how I grew up. No locked doors.
Yeah, exactly.
You don't have privacy. What's yours is mine. Oh, Drew, found my porn stash in the legendary virtual reality porno with Jenna Jameson. Was that I don't recall that. A virtual reality porno with Jenna Jameson. Okay, I guess they found his porn stash. Yeah, a lot of porn stashes getting found. Damn. My mom gave me $20 each week for school, lunch, or snacks. Being a kid as I spent it, but from freshman to senior year, $20 a week, I could have had at least right now $2,000. Yeah, Dave, I don't think you get the point of the break, buddy. Let's go to the phones. Let's talk to Zach on line one. Zach, good morning.
Good morning, boys. Thanks for calling. Sir, my mom found my whiskey stash. That got confiscated.
Wait, how old were you when she found it?
Oh, 24, but as you know, I can tie one on, and I was drinking a little much. And
you're 24. Well, how do you got to stash your whiskey? You should just have it laying out.
I know, but I had to hide it because I was told not to drink as much.
Yeah,
because
you're an idiot and you drink too much.
Yeah, okay. Maybe
knock
that
it
was
off!
Her saving you from yourself. You turn into a hornball when you're all drunk. Thank you, buddy.
It's on me when he's drunk.
Hey, let's.
And I'm going to take him up one of these days.
One of these days, I mean, he's got broad shoulders and he's got that new Bronco and it's looking nice. We might end up in the back seat.
You won't be able to walk for a week.
Chris, good morning.
Good morning. So when I was a kid, I stole hermit crabs from the church me and my parents went to, and I put them in a lunchbox.
What?
Took them home, completely forgot about them until they started stinking up the house, and my parents found them.
Oh, you stole from a church!
You stashed bodies that you stole from the house of the Lord?
You're right. Yeah. Okay,
this is a serial killer origin story. You know that. In a few years' time, we're going to come to find out you've been making soup bowls out of human skulls. What did you plan on doing with the hermit crabs?
I don't know. I was like 9 or 10. I just wanted to keep them as pets because my parents always told me I couldn't have them.
I mean, they were going to find them eventually. That's funny. This kid stole pets. He had a pet stash somewhere. But, you know, as much as I give you guff, Chris, thank you for the call. Robert Hartman, he hid a dog in his shed.
Oh, God.
Well, it only lasted like 2 days, but he found a stray and fed it, and the dog just followed him home. And that he made the dog a bed in his shed.
Oh.
And his parents said he couldn't have one. And then one day he comes home, and the door has been opened to the shed, and I guess they shooed the thing away.
Oh.
But he had a dog stash for 2 days. Cute little thing.
When my son was 12, I found a pile of melted plastic army men and learned I had a little pyromaniac. We've all been there. We've all melted some army men or something, right?
Yeah, my bit was, if it wasn't like, you know, a couple of blackjack firecrackers, I would hold their faces up to the wheel of a exercise bike and just buzz their faces down. Yeah, yeah. I probably should have talked to somebody on a sofa. Angela, my stash was found, and my stash were my journals. Mom found my stash of journals.
Oh, and did she read them all?
Yes, she did.
Oh!
And what she read was that Angela was, hey, it's a Pitch a Bitch Wednesday, was pitching a bitch about her mom all the time. So you find this stash of journals, you crack it open, oh, God, please don't be having sex with a varsity football player, and it turns out, God, mom's being such a bitch again. That's got to sting as a parent to crack that thing open and find out that your kid has just been journaling how much they hate you. Oh, that sucks. Yeah.
Came home one day. My mom had gone through my bottom drawer dresser looking for a pair of shorts for my dad. Found three bottles of liquor. They were going out of town, so she poured them out and left them on the cabinet. So when I came home, they were already on the road to wherever. Came home to three empty bottles sitting out.
Oh, gotcha. No. Got your ass. Josh, did a sweet little Spiegs ever hide anything from Mom?
Stash, dude?
Pa Dukes?
Did you have a stash, dude?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
I didn't have a stash, but there was something, one thing that I kept under a chair in my room. It was a Playboy. And one other time, I bought remember that Madonna sex book?
Of course I remember the Madonna sex book.
So much publicity. It was filthy.
Yeah.
And it never should have been published. But
Isn't it called Sex?
Yeah, it's called Sex.
The Sex.
Yeah, my buddy's older sister had a copy.
Yeah, and so I put that under. But I
how the hell did you get that? You bought it?
That was a coffee table.
Yeah, it was like a coffee table. It was like this thing.
Yeah,
it was huge.
I mean, that thing was very large.
Yeah.
You ran a batch to that thing?
Oh, hell yeah, he did.
I don't know anything
about
it. Wait,
so you masturbated Madonna on the regular?
No, I don't do that.
Good for you, buddy.
You and I were getting off to the same stuff.
But I eventually threw it all away.
I'm looking at pictures of it. There's a lot of foot licking.
A lot of S&M, right?
So many chains and leather and black and white photography and bush. Oh, my God. Gavin Rosdale isn't familiar with this much bush. Wow, look at that. And the Playboy, do you happen to recall? Because that was when Playboy Playmates were still somewhat of a thing.
Yeah.
Who's the Playboy Playmate of July? You don't recall?
No, but I think I recall one woman on a motorcycle.
From the Madonna sex book?
No, from the
the Playboy.
Yeah.
Could have been an Easy Rider, maybe. Magazine?
Oh no, it wasn't that magazine. It was in the Playboy. I'm even uncomfortable saying the word Playboy.
Okay. Why?
I had a stack
of nudie magazines.
It's just
I had
very
Swank, High Society, Wee, Hustler. Playboy never got
all
it done.
Those.
Yeah,
I had High Society,
Penthouse.
What else was the good ones?
Ebony.
Barely Legal.
Yeah, I hate to have to involve a lawyer. Temptation, Ecstasy, Derriere.
You're the same age they are.
Cherry. Great point. That's the only person that should be allowed to read Barely Legal. If you're like a 50-year-old guy and you have to consult, if you have to consult your legal team to look at porno, don't look at it.